Hello, and welcome to Van Slam's Vespa Garage. Since it's getting a little too chilly outside for warm-blooded people like myself, I have decided to combat the cold by adding a Tucano Urbano Thermoscud lap apron to my Vespa LX150. Enjoy! The lap apron is sold by Tucano Urbano, an Italian company. The lap apron is actually made in China. Once I placed the order on Wheel Up's website, it took 2 days to get here via FedEx. Everything for the lap apron came in a nice, neat bag. But baby, it's cold outside. Inside the bag, you'll find the lap apron. Also enclosed is a package in which you will find instructions written in several different languages, including English, and plastic adhesive protectors, and the lower anchor strap, and a Tucano Urbano keychain. One side of the apron is made of a waterproof, windproof material. If you look underneath, you'll find a fake fur material to keep you warm. So, let's start putting this thing together. I laid out my instructions and the plastic adhesives, and the tools I'll be using is a Phillips head screwdriver and an X-Acto razor. I also laid out the lower anchor strap for the apron, and most importantly, my Tucano Urbano keychain for emergency purposes. I first wrapped the front of the apron with the Velcro straps around the scooter headset. To double check the fit, I looked underneath the apron to see how the inside straps fitted on the scooter body. Once I was happy with this fit, I tightened the Velcro straps to the headset. Next, I removed the screw from the turn signal. I then took the same screw and placed it through the apron tab, and then replaced the screw back into the turn signal slot. I repeated the process for the other side of the scooter. To protect the undercarriage of the scooter, I placed one of the plastic adhesive strips where all the plastic clips would meet. Then using the X-Acto knife, I cut a hole in the plastic strip to prevent water from pooling up and rusting the bottom of the scooter. I then mounted the anchor strap at the bottom rear of the scooter next to the swing arm. I then attached the left front strap to the center anchor strap. Then I attached the right front strap to the center anchor strap. This is what it looks like when all the straps are connected. When I was satisfied with the fit, I then tightened all the straps securely. Once everything was snug and tight, I checked to see if I could open and close the glove box. I was able to do this without any problems. So I was done, and here's the left side of the scooter, and now the right side, with my new Thermoscud mounted. But wait, we're not done. Let's go over the big perks of the Thermoscud. If you go to the rear of the Thermoscud, you will find a pouch that is closed by a strip of Velcro. Opening the pouch, you will discover a strap that wraps around your neck and holds the Thermoscud bib to your chest. You should also find a protective piece that covers your rear seat in the case of a snow or rainstorm while the scooter is parked. On the lower left and right side of the Thermoscud, you will find two folded plastic tubes. These tubes lead to air channels which hold air to keep the side from flapping in the wind. Now if you look at the underside of the apron, where the bottom of the bib meets the fake fur underlining, you will find a zippered pocket. This pocket can be used for glove or map storage. Now under the bib, to the left and to the right, just below the fake fur lining, you'll find two straps with orange labels. If you unsnap these straps and place them under your legs, this will hold the sides of the scooter apron in place during those cold, windy days. At the front top of the apron, near the headset, you'll find a keyhole access panel with a bungee close-shut hinge. At the front of the apron, on the left and the right side, you'll find green threaded straps. These straps are used to hold the apron in place when you roll it up on a warm day, similar to what you would do with a sleeping bag. Well, that's it. Thanks for watching.